Hey everyone, Conscious back here. If you've been following along with the series so far, you should be having a scene that looks something that looks like mine. We're going to keep iterating over it. At the end of the last one, we built a little bit of our scene. I improved on it a little bit, and then I linked to the parallax background tutorial that I had. So if you haven't done that, you might want to follow that. But I'm going to put on the screen a time lapse of me building my current level along with the parallax background. And after that, we are going to get started on working on our jump mechanic, since that's one of the animations that we haven't implemented yet. And we're going to start there and also make some adjustments to our level along with our player camera. So let's get started. So here you can see our player, our camera's moving, the parallax background is working as intended. But I don't really like how it looks like the camera's centered on our player's feet. And if we go into our player scene, you're gonna see that that is where our camera is. It's right at the bottom, our player. So I'm going to move it up to be more in line with our player's chest. And now, when we do it, I think that looks just a lot better. Obviously our level still has some weirdness down here. We just have some empty gray. We are going to handle that later when we make some improvements to our level, but let's get into the jump mechanic right now. Okay, so now we're in our player script, and we want to be making some extra export variables that are going to help us make sure our jump looks as smooth as possible. So the first one that we're going to be adding is called airspeed. It's going to also be a float. I'm going to put it right now to 150. This is going to be our max speed while we're in the air. I don't have it as high as our ground speed. It seems more natural that you're not traveling as fast as you were in the air when you're jumping, but we can always tweak that again because it's an export variable, so we can fine tune to the exact value that we want for there. Our next export variable is going to be what we're calling air acceleration. It's also a float. I have it at 0.1. This is how quickly we're going to reach max air speed. Our last export variable for jumping is going to be what we call jump force, also going to be a float. I'm going to have this equal to negative 400. This is our initial upward jump force. And as a reminder, it's negative because in Godot, going up on the y-axis, we go into the negatives. So that's why we're going negative. We want to go up. And now we want to be able to handle our movement in the air, in the ground, and handle our jump. So I did make one small update here from our last video. I'm calling this now handle ground movement. So you might want to update that on your end. The next update I'm going to make is I'm going to create the process function up here. It's another built-in Godot function, similar to physics process, but we're not using anything physics related for it. I'm actually going to pull out the direction here on handle ground movement. It's not just going to be used in ground movement, it's going to also be used in our air movement. So I'm going to pull this out and add it here, so we're getting a constantly updated direction regardless of which, if we're in the air, if we're jumping, if we're on the ground, etc. Okay. So what we're going to do next is if we're not on the floor, again, that means we're jumping or falling, right? So we are going to do handle air movement, which is a method that we haven't created yet, but we will. We're going to do that next. And so if we're not on the floor, so we're in the air, else means we're on the floor, we are going to do our handle ground movement. So you can see right now, nothing has changed. I'm going to comment this out. I should be able to go play this, and nothing has changed. I'm still able to do this just as we were before, so nothing has changed. All right, I'm going to uncomment this out, and now we are going to implement our handle air movement, and then something we're going to call handle jump. All right, so for handle air movement, we are going to need access to our direction again, right? So if there's a direction, we're gonna modify our air movement. I'm just gonna put pass for now. And then we're also gonna have else. So if we don't have a direction, if we're at zero, first thing we're gonna do here is if we have a direction, we want to update our velocity, right? So we're gonna do velocity.x because we're going horizontally. And we're going to use a new method here. It's going to be called lerp, which is linear interpolation. If you don't know what that is, that's okay. I didn't as well. But what we're going to be doing, or what it does, is we give it velocity.x, which is our starting velocity. And then we give it a target velocity, which is our direction times airspeed. Right? And then how fast we're going to get there, which is our air acceleration. Cool. We'll demonstrate this once we have everything set up with our handle jump. We just have to write a little bit of code in order to be able to do that. In else, we are going to do velocity.x equals another linear interpolation, which is velocity.x, which is our starting velocity. Our target velocity is going to be zero because we're stopping. And how fast we're getting there is our air acceleration times 0.5, which we could pull this out into, you know, a deceleration variable. But for right now, I'm not going to do that. We can always come back to that. This is going to handle our air movement. So while we're in the air, now we need to actually make our guy jump, right? We haven't actually listened for the input yet. We have the animation set up. So if we're not on the floor, we're doing one of these two animations, but we actually haven't listened for our jump input mapping, which we've already set up. Again, minus space, you might have had something different. So what we're going to be doing for this, it's pretty simple, where it's if input is action just pressed, and it's the string of our input mapping. We're also going to listen or look for, just to make sure that our player is on the floor. I don't want him to be able to continuously jump. We could add a double jump down the road, but for right now, we just want to do a single jump. This is where we do our velocity.y, and it's going to equal the jump force. So that's where our jump force comes into play. And then we need to make sure we're actually going to handle the jump, which we can put in here into our physics process. So that's why we're doing this check if we're on the floor, right? Because in our handle jump, they could be pressing this space bar, but if they're not on the floor, it's not going to do anything. We're just going to move into our update animations. So let's see if we have a little bit of this now. Play this, still can move. There you go. You can kind of see if I stop, I don't just come to a complete stop, sort of like how our character here comes to a complete stop. Our character has a more like gradual sort of dropping. It seems a little bit more natural. It doesn't seem natural that you would just immediately kind of come to a stop like we do here. So while we're at it, maybe we should update our ground movement a little bit. Actually, no, I think our ground movement is fine. Right, the one thing we're not doing is flipping our animation if we end up turning in the air, so we can handle that pretty easily as well, which we'll be able to copy this from our ground movement and just do this here. So this should fix it. Yep. If you like that, you can keep it. If not, you can leave it as is. But this is our basic ground movement setup right now, which I think is our jump animation, sorry. Think this is looking pretty good. It's looking pretty good. Okay, so now that we have that handled, I do want to improve on our level a little bit. So right now, obviously, when we play it, there's this ugly gray background that we have. I don't like that. I don't think that that should be there. I would rather have a color that's maybe a little bit darker than our darkest background or this dark purple there. So we're going to create a new script. So we're going to go into our scenes folder. We're going to create a new folder. Call it levels. Inside of the levels, we're going to create a new script. We're going to call it level. Inside of the level script, and give this a class name, call it level. And then we don't need this method. We just want to do something. We want to change the background color anytime that this level is loaded, right? So what we're going to be doing is we have to go to what is called rendering server dot set default clear color. Let me use color. We can do dot. I'm just going to choose one of these as an example. We can just do black for right now, just to give you an example of what this is. Now, when I hit play, oops, nothing happened because I didn't actually assign that script to our test scene. So let me put. Sorry, here we go. Now we have it assigned. All right, cool. Now we can see that it's black everywhere that isn't here. I don't think that that looks good, but I think this gives you an idea of what you can do here. I'll show you when we fall off, we just keep going forever, all black. We'll fix that later as well. Let's see if we can find a color that works better. But I also did notice that in my background, I want to fix something. So this blue on the background layer, I want to bring this up here. I think this will look better too in our background layer. As well. Okay. Down. All right. So now the edge. Yeah, we have an edge here. Obviously, I don't like that edge. We're going to handle that as well. We're going to work on some more camera stuff in the next tutorial. So keep an eye out for that one. But for right now, I want to find a color that works best for our rendering. Okay, so what we're going to do is actually use the exact hex code. I'm going to be using the hex code from our skyline image that we use as our background and get the darkest purple in there. I can put the exact hex code in the description, so you can just copy and paste it. But what we're going to do is access color. You can see here it gives me a little bit of some type hints where we're going to do the code. We're going to add a string. Just pop this in there. Now when we hit play, I think that looks a lot better. It looks more natural to me, right? Like it's a consistent flow for our level. All right. I think that's it actually for this episode. We're gonna dive more into the camera next time. So you know, this looks a little wonky, right? Like we have buildings going off the edge on no platform. We can just fall off over here. You know, we're gonna make some improvements there, but that tutorial will be coming out soon. So make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.